terrifying in the first was how real and relatable the situation felt. And the deliberate slow build of tension, something Stray at Night isn't really interested in. It's all about thrill, John Carpenter homages, and wall-to-wall energy, which, don't get me wrong, isn't inherently a bad thing. Despite the killers feeling different due to this massive tonal shift, as well as different actors and mask appearances,